Hello, hello everyone. It's Michelle Packer here. Thank you for joining me. It's Wednesday, the 24th of April, 2024. And so welcome if you are new to my channel and this is the first time that you've seen me on video. So welcome and thank you. And I hope you enjoy today's class to go. So today it's slightly different. It's not live video. Because I am actually pre-recording this earlier in the week because I will be away this week at a kids camp. I'm volunteering along with one of my boys. We're volunteering as a helper, as helpers at this kids camp. So we're going to be gone all day, all week, and there's hardly any reception there. So I had to pre-record all these things. So if I were to keep up to my schedule, keep on schedule. So I'm going to flick you over. Today we are going to be, this is my last week because if you are not familiar, if this is new to you, Stampin Up, we have a new catalogue launching in May. And so this will be my last Wednesday featuring current products that are retiring at the end of April. Okay, so the product that we're working on today is called the Notes of Nature. There is a bundle, so there's a stamp set, and also this is how I tend to store them. They don't come together. So this is the Notes of Nature dies, so it coordinates with this stamp set. They are sold separately, but you can get them as a bundle with a 10% discount if you wanted to, or you can get just the stamp set, or you can get just the dies, but I find that's usually better if you can just get them as a set, because then you have everything you need coordinating. And so that's just how I tend to store my sets that are together. So, so there are 9 dies in here. Including this really cool, like, you know, notebook, the tops of a page, of a notebook page, with the holes in them, and then this fancy, I don't know what you call it, branch with leaves, and then we have all these other, and these 3 open dies coordinates with, 1, 2, and which one was that? Would that be the flower? Yeah, that would be the flower, that one there. Okay, so these you can find on page 43, right, so of our catalog. Sorry, I forgot to turn the light down. Okay, in such a hurry. Let's change things around a bit. Oh, here we go. Let's adjust these. Sorry. Okay, so we've got these from page 43, and you've got some samples, you've got, you know, the dies, it tells you the stamps and then the dies, and then together as a bundle. It is part of a collection. It's part of the Nature Sweetness collection, which included, which is the whole thing with 2 stamp sets and dies, actually. 2 sets of stamp sets and dies, which is that one there as well, which is the Lovely and Sweet stamp set with the Lovely and Sweet dies, and then it has the papers as well. Now that paper is actually carrying over, so from the 1st of May you can still get these. Okay, you can still get the paper. You can't get the stamp set. Actually, I'm not sure about Lovely and Sweet. I don't actually have that one. I think that one might be carrying over as well, but I don't actually have that stamp set. So the one I have is this one, and so I wanted to do one last hurrah with it, right? Before we say goodbye to it. All right, so class to go. So I have 2 projects to show you. So the way the class to go work, if you are new, welcome again. I'm going to be demonstrating 2 projects. And so, obviously, it's free for you to watch, and you are welcome to case it, to get ideas from it, and to make your own project with it, which is why I share them, so that you can So hopefully that, you know, you can get ideas from it and you can go on and make your own cards. That's what I'm about. I'm really just wanting you guys to make cards, okay? But I also wanted to make it easy for you. So I have these kits prepared, and so if you place an order with me this week right through till Tuesday, I don't know what date Tuesday is, whatever date that is, a week from now. So then I will be sending you these card kits for free. Okay, two of this and two of this. So the two designs and two of each. So there are four card kits that I'll be sending it to you, and so you can recreate at home. All right, firstly, project number one. I'm going to show this project. Now, as you can see, the color palette from here, if you look at all the samples, you can kind of think of it, you know, you can be stuck in that kind of color palette, which is what I would generally do. I'm guilty of it. And so sometimes I like to think of it, you know, like I like to challenge myself and try and think, can I make these in different colors? And so this week, or last week, Global Design Project came to the rescue because they have these colors. It was a color challenge over at Global Design Project. So the color challenge was Lemon Lolly, Fresh Freesia, and Balmy Blue. So I thought I would create a card with the stamp set using this color palette. Yeah, so anyway, this is the project that I've come up with. Let me see if I can bring you the sample. Here we go. So that's what I've come up with. And you may have seen this in my social media actually last week, because I did this. I included this in the challenge. I participated in the challenge, so I submitted this project, and so I am also doing this in our class. All right, so what you'll get in the card kit is, as you can see, some of the die cuts in the More Dazzles paper, which is also retiring. So we've got those, so little elements, and that one too, little strip. And then we have a card base, which is a basic white thick cardstock. And then we have Balmy Blue. Your kit will come pre-die cut already. So, okay, so it'll be, which way did I do it? Must be that way. Yeah, it must have been that way. I would have done that, pre-done that, so that it's okay if you don't have the dies. The only thing is that if you don't have the stamp set, you're going to have to get the stamp set, or you're going to have to replace and substitute with a stamp set that you have that can work with the elements here as well. So just with Stampin' Up policy, I'm not allowed to stamp them for you. You know, I'm not allowed to include stamped images in my kits. So therefore, I can give you the die cuts, but not the stamp images. So firstly, you're just going to need this. And then you have these two. That's for stamping. Now, I pre-did this just to save a little bit of time because this is a pre-recorded video. It's not live. So you can go ahead, if you're crafting along, you can go ahead and pause and stamp your images on here three times in Memento Black ink. Okay, we're just going to have the black ink. And three times, and then die cut it out with the dies. Or it's actually fairly easy to what we call fussy cut, to just follow the outline, cut it out. Now, if you notice, when I fussy cut, I don't actually go right on the black line. I always leave a little border, just like the die cuts usually do. Just simply, actually, these ones were die cut. I mean, sorry, these ones were hand cut. So you can tell the difference. See, I've actually cut it closer. I don't know if you can see. I've cut closer to the line than the die cut. But I often find it's more forgiving than if you try to cut it right on the line, okay? So that's my secret, my tip to a good fussy cut. All right, so I've pre-done this, but you would be stamping on here and then cutting it out. So go ahead and pause the video So you can catch up if you're crafting along, you can do all that. And then hit play again when you're ready. So what I will do is to stamp on here. Why haven't I got a piece of paper? Let me just have my piece of paper to protect my surface. All right, so just going to put these up here on the side so that you can actually see what I'm doing. Right, so what this is a collage style, right? So I'm going to have that. Oh, I don't think I cleaned it. Let me just give it a good clean because I think it's got ink. So this is my chamois. It's very well used and it doesn't look very pretty, but that's okay. It's not mold. It's just stains from all the ink, because I do use it a lot. Okay, I'm just cleaning this to make sure that it is clean. Okay. Sometimes things don't get done properly here. Like, I should have cleaned all this before. Just to make sure that, yeah, nothing gets like put in the wrong ink, you know. All right, so this card, we're gonna just use. So these are the color palette from Global Design Project. So here, Balmy Blue, so I'm gonna go monochromatic with this, tone on tone. All right, I'm going blue on the blue. And so it's a matter of just, I'm just inking and then just kind of randomly, you know, just kind of, it's a random thing. So I might just put it around here. Okay. And then maybe a third one right about here. Okay, so it's real random. And then we're going to go with this one as well. Maybe about here. So we've got that. So this is a really cool one. I love these kind of stamps, because it means you, it's not like, you know, you've got to stamp it right in its proper place. It can be pretty random. So now I've got all these splatters as well, which I can just kind of, you know, just kind of fill in the empty spaces. Yep. So real nice and simple. Okay, just to give it some interest instead of just a plain blue. All right, so now we've got some sort of interest in here. All right, and so that's my balmy blue for that color. And then, well, I probably should clean it right now because we'll be using these stamps again. So wouldn't it be nice if I have an assistant? Love to have an assistant so that I can go, I'm moving on, can you please clean this while I'm moving on with the project. But it's great if you're crafting along, then you can catch up too. Alright, so let's get that out of the way for now. Alright, so we've got this. So the next step, really, I'm just going to distress this. Okay, I'm just going to, like, just like in real life when you tear a page out of a notebook, right? So there's kind of like, it's all crumpled and ugly. Oh, do you want a secret? Do you want to know something behind the scenes? So we don't always get it right, right? I mean, I think sometimes, you know, you see only the best of us, right? The best that we've done. So you've seen these projects, you know, in my social media, and it's because it's the one that I'm happy with and I've take a nice picture of it, but you don't see what I went through before I got to this stage. So let me show you the first, the original card that I made, that I started with, and then I went, and you will understand when I show you my dirty secrets. Here we go. Ta-da. I started with the lemon lolly as the background. And then I couldn't decide whether to do, how to do my leaves, whether I want fresh freesia on white, or fresh freesia on fresh freesia, or black on white, and then color it with fresh freesia. And I eventually went with the fourth option, which is the black on the fresh freesia. So many options, right? Anyway, so when I couldn't decide, so I went all three. And then with the lemon lolly, I did the same thing. I stamped that, but you can't see it as well with the lemon lolly. But then I also had this clever idea of distressing it. So I crumpled up the paper. You know, I just went, pick up the paper and just crumple it. You know, it's kind of like, I know some people all have a heart attack probably saying, how could you do that to cardstock? Anyway, I did that. And so it looked crumpled. Not quite. No, it didn't turn out the way I wanted it to. So I left it uncrumpled here. You are most welcome. If you like that look, you're most welcome to crumple it. Anyway, so here you go. That's the first card I made that I decided wasn't the emphasis I liked. I think I preferred the blue and a little bit of lemon lolly, and stuck with the purple, the fresh freesia flower. Here you go. Okay, so that was my reject card, and this is the one that I'm happy to teach in the class. All right, so where does this go? Okay, so this, now I can glue it down straight on here. So yeah, nothing fancy, it's just distressing that. I could even distress this even more. So either use your finger or use your paper snip, your scissors, just kind of distressing. I didn't quite distress that one too much. Well, I'm just doing it here so you can see the difference. And then you can decide which one you like better. So that if you do get the kit, you already know what you're going to do. Or perhaps you would do the same. You would leave one clean and straight and nice, and then the other one a little bit more distressed, like this one. So let's glue this on. So this is nice and easy to do. Okay, just go there, go there. All right, and nothing too hard about this part. It's just putting it straight on there, nice and simple. Okay. And then we have a little strip, didn't we? What did I do with it? Pardon me. Oh, where did that strip go? Well, I have one here. But you should have one in a yellow strip with this. It'll probably appear when I don't want it. Okay. Just double check it's not down there. Okay, well, I do have one here anyway. Okay, and then we are going to stamp this with Memento Black Ink. I'm just going to say the same thing. Today is all about you. Happy birthday. Okay. Ooh. Just test it out. Okay, that might be good. Here we go. Does that look good? Look alright, eh? If in doubt, let's try it on the other side. Two sides to paper. I'm going to try it on here too. Okay, well, I think this one might be slightly better. Okay, so, and then I'm just going to angle this. So I'm just following where the angle of the T. So I'm not going like this. I'm not going like this. It's too flat. I'm just trying to parallel with the T. Okay? Okay, so put that away, so that's ready to go. And then I have these flowers, so I've got three. Right, so kind of was gonna do that. I'm gonna bring in my stamping seal, so I'm just gonna, which that's the nice part, that's the ugly one. Okay, I'm just gonna, okay, have some sticky on there so that I can, oh actually I also need this, don't I? Okay, I need this going further down. Wait, let me bring in this, my other trusty thing. I like using this when I'm working with glue, because then if I get glue on the surface, it just rolls off the silicone mat. Okay, I've just added some glue so that I can, I did it on the wrong side, silly me. Okay, here we go. Third time's a lucky, third time's a charm. What am I saying? Okay, so I've got this so that I can just pick up like that. Okay, so you can see some shininess. And then I'm going to have that layered like so, I think. How do I want this? I think I want it more like that. I think we'll do that. And then I need to slip this in as well. Okay, so that's kind of going there. It's just little hints of, what do you call it? Little hints of silver and glitter on the card. Which might not seem a lot, but I think it makes a difference. And then I'll have one going down the side here as well. Just kind of peeking out. Okay, so then that now can go. If I move that out of the way, then you can see a bit better. Then now that can go on here, but we do want our little silver trim. These are retiring as well, but you'll get them in the kit. If you don't already have them, then you can still use it. So I'm just gonna, all I did was just coil it and then, you know, gonna flip this over and gonna stick it on here like so. Okay, leave it. Whoa, it's working really well for me today. Sometimes it's just not, it has its own mind and it's doing stuff, you know, that I don't want it to. So let's see there. Kind of a bit messy kind of look, but that's the way. You don't want it too uniform, right, because then it just doesn't look natural. So yeah, so that's all I want it to do, so it looks different to other one as well. And I'm actually going to be, I'm going to be using dimensions on these, so let me pull out the dimensionals. So I have, what I do with these big hexagon is I cut them in half. I don't know, I just like to be able to spread it around. So I feel like I can do that a lot better when they're smaller. And, you know, it's like I can spread it out a bit better. Because when they're big, they're also a bit cumbersome. Maybe here. And maybe one more here. Okay, let's see if I remember what I did. Okay, now it's just a matter of picking up all this. Okay, just taking the backing off. It can be a bit of a mission sometimes. But you know what helps is, what did I do with it? Sometimes using this. You know, you're just poking it and, so that helps sometimes. Just poking it and taking it off. Oops. Maybe not. Didn't work as well. Okay, here we go. I have got everything, all the stickies off. Okay, and then I can just put this on here on an angle. Or not on an angle, rather. Ta-da! Right, and then now with the classic dots. What did I do with my classic dots? Ooh, Let me. I can't find my classic dots. Oh, I don't know what I've done with my classic dots. But I can use. I will use that one because that's already open. That's my rustic metallic dots. I do like rustic metallic dots too. So you can have a choice. Let me just have one more quick look because it's kind of a pain. Oh, here we are. I knew I have it somewhere. So I'm just using the grey one. Okay, so I'm going to have the same. I think I'll just do the same. So put one there. Or I don't. Or I can just leave it there. Oops. I just dropped one. Okay. So there you go. Two cards. Right, I mean, so that's what you'll get. Two kits for this one design. So I hope you like that and enjoy that. I think it's a cute card. And yeah, so it's just different color palette to what we see on the catalog. So something different. And thanks to Global Design Project. So hop, go along to that website and you'll be able to see other ideas of what people have done using these colorways as well. So yeah, so we all it's funny how like the same color palette, you know, and you can get some quite different look. Okay, so that's card number one. Now let's move on to card number two. Card number two, now I will show you what inspired this. Okay, so the colorways that we're using with this are these, and I just think they're just so yummy. I mean, I just love these colors together. And this is the project that inspired it. So I got this birthday card from a good friend of mine that I know through stamping. It's amazing what friendships we get just through crafting together. And yeah, and she lives down the road from me, Susan, and she gave me this wonderful birthday card, which I love. And so I replicated it. I taught this in my class, in-person class in April, and right now, and I'm doing like a version of this, not entirely, yeah, but similar, definitely using the color palette anyway. So that is a cool card, eh? So that uses the sweet moments, memories, and more card, which I believe are still available. So if you don't have that, grab those. They're just amazing cards. So good to use for anything. Yeah, here you go. So that's the inspiration behind this color palette. So I've shown you two ways today where I get my color palette from, like from a design challenge and from cards that people have made and given to me. So there you go. So this is more in line with you know, what we see on the catalog with this stamp set. So we've got, what do we have here? Actually, when I first made this card, and I thought I'll teach that, but it's the same card, it's just different color palette again. But sorry, it's the same color palette, but different emphasis. So this is the card that uses Smoky Slate, which is also the color in this range, right? So we've got Pecan Pie, Smoky Slate, and Pretty Peacock. Those are the three colors. And so this one here, the emphasis on the card base, obviously, is Smoky Slate, as opposed to this one, which will be Pretty Peacock. And Pretty Peacock is on there. So the stamping, we have all three colors. And this, I went with Fresh Fija because I thought it goes well with the Smoky Slate. I actually started with a yellow, because you can see. I actually started with a yellow first, and then I kind of go, I don't know. I think it's all right. I think crushed curry goes well with a lot of colors. But I think I prefer the fresh freesia with the smoky slate. So this was the first. So actually, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to change things up a little bit. So normally I give you the same thing, two card kits, right, for this project, and I'll give you the same thing. So this time I'll give you one in that color and one in that color. So there you go. Just change things up a little bit. Go with something different. Okay, so the card base, and then you have the insert. It's because it's a pretty dark color. So you want to have a white card there so that you can write something on there and it will be visible. And then we've got a layer of pecan pie, and that's the matte layer to go so that the white stamp layer will go on top of it. And then we have this, and then we have this long thing that I told you about that I love from this dies. And I cut it with the More Dazzle paper, so sparkly and shiny. But we only use bits of it because, as you can see, it's only these two here. All right, so just cut them. So you've got extras for other things that you can use. You'll get one for each card, so you'll get extras. I'm not being stingy. I'm not giving you just one for both of your cards. Okay. All right, so let me see. What do we need to do? I'm leaving this blank. I'm not stamping on it, but you're welcome to. And then, so this is the piece that we want to stamp on. All right, so we've got this. Let me move that aside first. Let me bring in this. Certainly don't want. Now, when I did this, I actually did this vertically. So I'll just do that. Okay, making sure there's no balmy blue. Oh, no, yeah, there's no balmy blue. Oh, and I'll move these colors out of the way because we're not using these colors now. So we're bringing in smoky slate first. Okay. So smoky slate. And I'm going to go, where did I have this? Kind of like this. Yep, feel notes. And feel notes. I think I just had the two. Yep, that's cool. Happy with that. And then, you know what? And also, while I'm at it, maybe I'll do it on the inside as well. Sure what this is. Is this the date 6th of July 2022? I'm not sure. Sometimes I really want to get into the head of these the designers that did it. Like what were they doing? What were they thinking? Like, you know, what was the inspiration behind all that? You know, so yeah, anyway, so move that out of the way. And then we need this, which is again making sure there's no balmy blue. Pretty sure I cleaned it, but you know, you can never tell. Oh, that was the inside. Yeah. You can see it's just nice and simple, eh? You don't have to think too much, I think. You know, like there's no correct place to put things. You know, just kind of put them down somewhere. So like that. And then maybe something like that. Cool. Alright, that's the pecan pie. Can move that out the way. Oh, I do need this. But first, I'm going to bring in this. I'm going to bring in this little floral bit as well. For and pretty peacock. And so we're just going to bring in a little bit of green-ish to there. Maybe one coming down. Peekaboo there. Oh, and then so they're not going to be the same. Okay, they look so different when you want to compare. Okay, so I'm happy with that. Yeah, happy with that. And then what I'll do is do the gray, fill in with this. These stamps are so good to have. So any stamp sets that you see, and if they have those little dot things, they're so good. Just make sure you get them. See? That just fills it up now. Where it looks a bit sparse before. Yeah. Done. What do you think? Maybe a little bit here as well. And maybe here. You can go a bit crazy. Is it busy? Is it too busy for you? Because for some people, you know, like this is way, way too busy. And some, it's just, I just think of it as that's just a style, right? Today, I'm not making clean and simple. Today, the style is it's not a clean and simple style. Now, what did I do? I keep losing my little piece. Yeah. Did you see that? I lost my crush curry. Where's it gone? No, it's here. Because I want it to, I may as well stamp the words now. So then all the stamping is done. So, again, if I don't get it right, it's two sides to the paper. Okay, stamping is a little bit ugly. Why is that? I think my thing is not very evenly inked up. My pad. Okay, that's slightly better. That's better than that, I think, because that one's got some parts are darker than others. Need to do some maintenance on that. Alright, let's move that out of the way. Make sure that's the right part. And now what do we need to bring in? I think I just need to assemble it now. So I'll bring in... Oh, what else do I need to... I need to stamp on here. I need to stamp... Do I want a bit of the green? I think I do. Okay, I'm going to do a bit of that. I'm just trying to get all the stamping done right, so then it's finished. Cool. And then maybe just slightly. One way. And a little bit of dots. Okay. Ooh. Nearly. Whoops. Okay, there you go. I'm happy with that. So, no overthinking, okay? Guys, don't overthink where you stamp things because then you take too much time. You want to get your cards done. You don't want anything to kind of hinder your progress, your productivity. But if you are enjoying the process, though, and you are happy thinking about it, then... By all means, do that. I just wanted to caution against overthinking things and then not getting things done. The important things. The important thing about making our card is getting the card done and sent to brighten up somebody else's day. So, well, it's important to me. So I don't want to have cards that are just sitting around. Although I do have a lot of them, because, yeah, I'm just clearly not sending cards as much as I should be, or as much as I want to. So I'm preaching to myself. Okay, so that's simple, and then that just goes straight on there. I'm not dimensionalizing this. Alright, so just go there, and then that's going on here. Oh, is it straight? Okay, use my grid paper, dear. Okay. I think that's looking straight enough. So I'm using that as my guide. Is that right? Oh my goodness. Okay, so it looks straight enough. So yes, and then that will go on here. But first I need to cut these. So I'm just bringing in a little bit of a shiny metallic into my design. So something like, maybe I'll do that one here. Okay, and then okay, so I've got that long piece left over for something else. So that's just going to go over here, and I don't want it sticking all the way out because then it might not fit into my, is that the right one? Yep. To my thing. So I'm just going to put some glue. Oh, come on. Come on, puppy. Yeah, here we go. And here we go. So sticking it out like that. liquid glue, so let it sit a bit. Something like that. And then this one here too. Maybe like that. That's kind of framing that. Okay. Then I just need to dimensionalize this. And this is card number 2, just about there. Did I do the insert already? Let's have a look. Do I want it here? Do I want more of that leaf showing? Maybe. Okay. Oh, hang on. Oh, yeah, I have done that. And that is card number 2. How cool is that? So we've got 2 colorways. I mean, they're the same color palette, just emphasis on different things, right? I know what I forgot to do. I forgot to shade that. Oh, well, there you go. You can see it now. You can keep it clean and simple. And that one I have actually sponged with our blending brush and the pecan pie. So I'm going to leave it as it is to show you the difference. All right, so you can decide whether you want it the more of a old worn book. Kind of goes with the whole feel notes look, you know, like tea stained kind of thing. Or you want to go for that nice clean and white look. So yeah, this is what I've done. I left it outside and the inside I left it clean. So maybe I could do the opposite in here. Or I'll just leave it clean. Anyway, but otherwise you just you know, ink it up and then you just kind of lightly just put your ink on to get the different colors, to get the older look, the old page look. What do you think? So we've got these 2 cards today. That's the first one right here. And so that's in the quite a different color palette, and maybe something that you might not have thought of because of, you know, what you see on the catalog. And that is what I have for you today. So thank you for joining me today, and thank you for coming along and staying with me and crafting with me. If you like the video, please do click on the like button and please share it. That's just really good for me if you do share it. And also, yeah, I think it's a good thing to be able to, you know, some people don't like to come up with ideas. And so being able to case and copy ideas, that helps. And that's what I like to do, what I like to be helpful. And also, yeah, don't forget, if you place an order with me, you can buy anything. You don't have to buy these products. You can buy anything from my Stampin Up shop, online shop, and as long as it's over $40, you'll be getting these cards for free from me. Now, of course, I won't be able to get to it, to packing the kit, until I get home on Friday night, actually, so probably in the weekend, but I'll post it to you as soon as I can on the Monday. All right, so thank you very much for joining me, and I hope you enjoy this. Next week when we come back, it'll be the 1st of May, or it'll be May anyway, I think. So we will be using current products, so like not products like these today here, because that's going to be retiring on the 30th of April. Okay, thank you very much. See you later.